afternoon, good morning, and good evening from whichever part of the world you're joining us. Priya Patro. Priya is an agile evangelist and a program manager in Capgemini, spearheading digital transformation, digital quality assurance, and quality engineering program for a large conglomerate in the life science domain. She is a prolific speaker for national and international conferences on agile and project management and Internet of Things. Some of her public speaking experiences include PMI Global Congress, North America 2017 in Chicago and 2018 in Los Angeles, PMI's Mumbai Chapter PM Conclave for 2015 and 17, PMI EMEA Congress 2018 and in 2019 in Dublin. Priya has been counted as the 51 most influential woman in India by Bridgebhumi Foundation in April 2019, and also named in the 50 inspirational women project managers across the globe by Eliza Stevens as part of her Celebrating Women in Project Management series in 2018 and 19. So without much ado, over to you, Priya.
Thank you, Sion, for the wonderful introduction. I don't know from where you got that, but it was really good. So with that, let us elevate our project management technology quotient. Swati, we are going through a project or a budget freeze, said Jane. The IT manager of the pharmaceutical company that Swati was managing a program for. And this pharmaceutical company has been going through a reorganization since Q2 2019. She had heard rumors about budget freeze, but she never believed them. Today, she heard it from the horse's mouth. So Swati thought, I must do something. I must be able to add value to my organization as well as stand by my customers in this hour of need. So curious mind that Swati was, she went back and she started a series of brainstorming sessions, not only with her teams, but with the other teams within the organization in the same domain. She wanted to find out inefficiencies in the business processes that was there and thereby reduce the cost for her customers. With the code freeze and the system freeze coming in Q4 2019, Swati decided to reskill and upskill her team in business process automation, in bot development, and other automation technologies. She started open hackathons with her team, her customers, suppliers, vendors, so as to include everyone to find out the best solutions for the system today. She even relooked at herself and reskilled herself in the agile way of working. And since there was a code freeze and the system freeze going on, her team also developed certain proof of concepts of bots. That is, the bot developed and augmented her team with the bot. Excited and happy that the customer was, but these bots could not be moved to production because of the budget constraints and the system freeze. A couple of months later, to be precise, March 22nd, 2020, as Swati was retiring for the night that day, she gets a call. And at the other end of the line was her shift manager. And he was excited, he was anxious, and he said, Swati, our system is showing an unusual surge of volumes of orders. We need to have our team on standby to ensure business continuity. Actually, because of the COVID situation, when the entire world went into lockdown, this pharmaceutical company suddenly saw a surge of orders, of the masks, of the syringes, of the other medical devices. The next morning, Swati and Jen went on for an SOS meeting. They discussed, they brainstormed, they deliberated, trying to find out ways how to manage the situation. Having the team working 25/7 was obviously not a feasible idea. They looked at the array of bots that the team had created, and voila, there was that one bot which could eliminate all this manual effort, expedite shipping, as well as read out the orders based on the priority. And that was Praswati's project management technology quotient. She was being agile all the way. She was always curious. She included everyone in the organization to find out a solution, and she built a future-proof talent pool. And that is the project management technology quotient that we are going to talk about today. So if you're like Swati, a project manager who's thinking, how do I thrive this new normal? What skills do I need to manage my projects better? Well, you have a tool. PMI has given us a guardrail, a framework for the skills of the future, which is the project management technology quotient. And what is this all about? It is always on curiosity. That means keeping your eyes open and trying to ability to adapt and take a new business ideas, new technology, new ways of working. It is not about jumping into the bandwagon and following every new digital trend, but it is about looking at those technologies, looking at those new ideas, and see what is best for your project. And the next is the all-inclusive leadership. It is about including everyone, irrespective of gender, generation, position in the organization chart, level of the skills, because you never know from where you will get that stellar idea, and building a future-proof talent pool. We all know about reskilling and upskilling of our resources, making them future fit. But PMTK also talks about replacing and augmenting your teams with the bots. Yes, you heard me right. We are talking about replacing and augmenting our teams with the bots, so that all the repetitive and the mundane work can go to the bots, and we as project managers and our teams can concentrate on more creative and innovative work that comes our way. And all these three things that you see adds up to something which I took a privilege to add: agility all the way, ability to predict, adapt, and respond to the change. And that is what we call agility all the way. So I would request you to take a snapshot of this slide, because whatever we are going to talk after this will be based on the three components of PMTQ and the fourth one, which I took the privilege of adding. So I'll pause for a moment here now so that you can take a snapshot of this slide. Always on curiosity, all-inclusive leadership, future-proof talent pool, and agility all the way. Okay, I will now move on. So, carry okay, let's elevate the project management technology quotient. So how many of you all are aware of or have participated in a karaoke? You can click on the raise hand button on your WebEx window and let us know that. Okay, right. So how to karaoke? So people, those have raised their hands and said that they know how to karaoke, well and good. And those who don't know, no worries. We are going to tell you how to do this now. So here, everyone participates, just like we have a musical karaoke, here everyone participates. And there is no right and wrong. So cool is that. And click on the button, raise hand, see the picture that is displayed on your screen, and relate to one of the PMTQ components. I'm sure you've taken a snapshot, so you'll be able to relate to one of those components when you see the picture. And there'll be a poll that will come up for 20 seconds only. So you got to be fast, and you got to take the poll by answering which PMTQ component that picture relates to. And we will discuss more on that, and we'll have a lot of fun. I promise that's going to happen. So let us move on and let's karaoke. All right, Pratik, time to put on the poll now. when you look at this picture, what comes to your mind? And what comes to your mind means you have to relate to a project management technology quotient component here. So I see the poll already there, but for me, when I look at this picture, of this child, it reminds me of my child who always keeps asking questions. Mama, why do I have to eat the vegetables? Why can't I go down to the garden to play? Why do I have to wear this mask every time I go down? Yeah, why and why? And that is curiosity. Just as Eric Schmidt said, who was the CEO of Google from 2001 to 2011, said, Google is a company of questions and not a company of answers. So we would like to see what the poll is right now. Always some curiosity. Fantastic. It looks like people have got it right. It is about always on curiosity. Yes, that came to my mind when I saw this picture for the first time. I will now look into my lockdown diary. So I maintained a lockdown diary based on the incidents that are happening in my life and my project. Yes, and if you see this is a PMI diary which I got in Los Angeles. And I have maintained a lockdown diary. Let me look at this and narrate a story from my lockdown diary. It was March 30th. We were 1 week into the lockdown. Things had changed immensely and we were not very happy. We missed our in-cubicle friends. We missed our hallway impromptu conversations. We missed our chai ki charcha in the canteen. I could sense that undercurrent. I could sense that impatience in my team. Sometimes they were very irritated. Sometimes they were silent. My ever so innovative team has suddenly become complacent. And I had to do something. I had to shake things up. And that day, I decided one thing. Instead of having a stand-up meeting, I decided to have a why meeting, WHY meeting. And in that meeting, everyone was just supposed to ask questions. Be it be about the solutions that they are implementing, be it be about the technology that they were implementing, or be it be the business process that they were following. We were just supposed to ask questions. And that made creative juices flowing. And just last week, we were able to submit a proposal of adapting a new automation tools for the system. And this came out from this why meeting that we had. So if you see, notice, why is a very important word. Retain your curiosity to retain your learning. And that is the first principle of PMTQ, always on curiosity. All right. We will move on to the next now. Pratik, have the poll up now. And if you look at this, it is showing us about skills. And obviously, I will wait for you to take the poll. But when I look at it, I think about reskilling. I think about upskilling. I think about how to make my team future fit. Now, I got to take out another interesting nugget from my lockdown diary and see how making my team future fit has enabled us to do something great in this COVID era. Are we seeing the answers coming up? Well, I'm not able to see, but I'm hoping that you have guessed the answer by what I am talking now. Well, so it was again end of March, and I get a ping from Jayant in my official communicator. And Jayant says, oh, I get the answers now. It says future fit talent pool. Thank you. So I get a ping from Jayant on the communicator. And Jayant says, Priya, can you help me to find a project which matches my skill and my aspirations? I was shocked. Why is Jayant asking for a new project? He was just allocated to a project in the automotive sector. And he was part of the reskilling and upskilling of initiative that the organization had taken up in the last quarter. So Jayant tells me that his project is undergoing a heavy ramp down. And by the end of the week, he will be hitting the bench. And obviously, a bright mind like Jayant would not like to be idle. And while I was trying to reassure Jen about this entire situation, that things will work out good, there comes an email in my inbox, and that email was from our COO. And obviously, I could not ignore that email. And I browsed through the email. One interesting thing that struck my eyes was about an internal crowdsourcing platform that the COO was talking about. And that some interesting projects were also listed in the crowdsourcing platform. And he was looking for people who would take up this project so that they can reinforce their learning. And the projects were COVID-19 compliance solution or contactless proof of delivery. So when a parcel delivery person or a mail delivery person comes there, how can you take a contactless digital signature as a proof of delivery? So I asked Jayant to register himself on that crowdsourcing platform. I said, Jayant, why don't you register in that crowdsourcing platform and take up some projects? A couple of weeks later, and this time I get a call from Jayant on the communicator. No pain, this time it was a call. Excited that Jayant was, I realized something good might have happened to him. And he says that because they have taken up this project of contactless proof of delivery, he could clear an interview on the logistics sector and he could land himself up in the project. And obviously he was happy and excited about this new prospect. So it is about not only reskilling and upskilling your team, but ensure that this learning is reinforced to add personal value to the team member, to the project, as well as to the organization. All right, Pratik, time for the poll again. So what comes to your mind when you look at this picture? Okay, so I can see the poll up there, but when I look at this picture, I see different colors of shoes, which brings to my mind an idea of diversity. So I will have to look up in my lockdown diary again and narrate you a story, a nugget from my lockdown diary. Well, and incidentally, I have enlisted these instances in the Manage India magazine this month. Why diversity and inclusion is important in this COVID era and how we can become more inclusive leaders in this era. So according to a report that came out a few weeks back by PMI, 27% of the organizations are putting their diversity and inclusion initiatives in the back burner. Then I think that's probably not a good idea, because this is the time where we need people to be innovative, people to be more, to get those innovative and creative ideas to solve the problem. And I see that, you know, many people have got this right, all inclusive leadership. Now, let me pull out a nugget from that article and from my lockdown diary to see how I have leveraged this all inclusive leadership component of the PMTQ to enrich my team. So there was Rajesh. He is my DBA, a veteran person in the project, and has been very helpful. He's cheerful. He gels well with the team, but this is all which was there in the pre-lockdown era. Come the COVID era and the lockdown, Rajesh has not been attending the meetings. When he attends the meeting, he is quiet, and we are missing our old Rajesh now. Obviously, something was not right, and what I decided to do is take a one-on-one video call with Rajesh. The agenda was to review the database design. With the video on, Rajesh was not comfortable at all. He fumbled with the virtual collaboration tools, like the channels, like the virtual whiteboard, collaborative whiteboard. And he started stepping back. I realized, but Rajesh, who was from a little elder generation, is always used to face-to-face discussions, face-to-face meetings. And the sudden switch from the face-to-face to that of the virtual collaborative mode was making him nervous. He didn't want to tell anyone that he was not used to this collaboration tool. So he started isolating himself. Also, he was very anxious about his health, thinking that his age or his generation is more prone to the disease. And thereby, he was going more and more in the self-isolation mode. For the next couple of weeks, I started having virtual chai with Rajesh every day, 4 p.m. We got used to this entire collaboration medium and the tools. We also engaged Rajesh in the peer coaching circles, where people like Rajesh come together, talk about their problems, and find solutions on their own. And that's how we got our old Rajesh back to the team, and we brought him into the mainstream. All right, the next one. Prateek, time for the poll again. What comes to your mind, and what technology PM, project management technology quotient component can you relate to when you look at this picture? And I will give you a hint. This is a picture of a robotic pharmacy, which probably is in the Netherlands. And this robotic pharmacy can scan the prescription and dispose drugs based on the prescription. Now in this COVID era, like in the COVID time, where people are asked to go for contactless delivery, where our workforce have been displaced to other sections where we need them the most, this probably is a very good solution. It is again here where we are augmenting our team with the bots. See, where a couple of months back we were scared that bots are going to take away our job. And now bots are our real good friends. Incidentally, in December 2019, I authored an article for the PM Network magazine, and it was titled Bring on the Bots, where I talked about the different instances where bots were leveraged in my project. And some mundane tasks like timesheet tracking, creating the product backlog, stand-up call coordination, creating the data for root cause analysis. These were some of the instances where we had leveraged the bots. And when I went to look at it, yes, the bot augmented team is probably not the right answer. It is a future-proof talent pool, but that's fine. When we looked at it, when I look into my lockdown diary again to see where have I leveraged the bots during this lockdown period, well, let me look at it. Yes, the stand-up call coordination bot. Overnight, we all switched to the virtual mode. Coordination became difficult. People were in multiple meetings, and there were meetings all the day. So people started missing our stand-up call. And this was a bot which would pull in all everyone of the team into a common chat room where people would give updates on their tasks. They would highlight impediments, and the bot would highlight the impediments to the Scrum Master. Remember, we have not replaced the Scrum Master. We have just delegated the coordination task to the bot, just relieving the Scrum Master and the project manager to focus on something where there is value, so that they can focus more on the removal of impediments. All right, now to the last one. Pratik, can we have the poll again? Pratik is doing a good job as a poll master. Yes, and we have 30 seconds to take the poll, and I think everyone will get this right. Right, I will look up into my lockdown diary now again to see which PMTQ component does this picture relate to. All right, so we just have 6 more seconds, I think, and post that we will get the answer. For me, this looks like agility. This looks like agility all the way. And obviously we will get the answers in a few seconds, but I'm looking into my lockdown diary to see what incident, what nugget can I pull you out and share with you which relates to agility? Well, friends, everything that I have in this diary is about agility. It's about agility all the way. The fact that we flipped the switch from work from office to work from home is about adaptability. It's about agility. The fact that we all went virtual, getting adapted to Zoom, Skype, Teams, whatever it is, it's about adaptability. Fact that an infrastructure could support the 125,000 people that went from work from office to work from home, it's again about adaptability and agility. So it is agility all the way. The fact that we are having this virtual conference of 1,200 odd people attending this session is all about agility. And kudos to the West Bengal chapter team for making this happen. So there you are. That's your project management technology portion. Always on curiosity, all inclusive leadership, future-proof talent pool, and agility all the way. Want to know more about PMCQ? Well, there is a link here, and there's a report, how to make yourself future fit with PMCQ. And with this, project managers, project leaders, we are marching towards the new future. We are leading the way with project management technology portion, the PMTQ. And that is me. That's a caricature of me in the middle. And this is designed by my friend, Natasha. And I am a project manager, and I chase storms to relax. And I'm an agile evangelist, program manager, and a non-linear thinker. And I lead digital transformation programs. I also lead agile community of practice within my organization. It is a virtual collaboration platform of 546 members where we evangelize agile across all strata of the organization. Again, all inclusive leadership. And I do have some speaking experience. I've spoken in 4 global conferences so far. The 5th one is yet to happen. And when I'm not working, I'm dreaming about the future of work. And my views are expressed in the Future of PM Work blog on projectmanagement.com. So if you follow me on these hashtags, Future of PM Work, Speaker Priya, Agile, W2W, Words to the Voice, you will see what I'm doing. I'm also the brand ambassador of my organization, which means you will see a lot of posts by me highlighting the thought leadership of Capgemini on social media. And I was named as the top voices of Capgemini on social media in 2016. And these are my coordinates. I would love to connect with you and get your feedback, get your inputs on PMTQ. I would love to know how you have leveraged PMTQ or how you are going to leverage PMTQ in this new normal. So please do connect with me, and I would love to take this conversation forward. And with this, thank you.
Hi, Priya. Thank you very much. Extremely interesting session, and generally we get to ask the questions. Today you asked all the questions, so thank you very much. And I think PMTQ sets off to a fantastic start for the day in terms of what people can think next. A few quick questions though. Number one, for a team that has never worked on bots or any of the automation projects, what's a good starting point?
Okay, so what we usually do is we look at internal projects, right? Internal solutions. And then, of course, there is a big reskilling and upskilling initiatives going on in all organizations. We look at internal process, be it be a leave management process, right? Or be it be a timesheet tracking process. We have developed bots for that. And that's how we have leveraged our team or reinforced the learning for our team. And that's a good way, I think, to start.
Okay, so can you elaborate a little bit more about how automation works in non-IT industry? There are some specific questions around how do we use it in engineering and procurement-based companies or construction-based companies?
That's a very tough question because I'm from an IT industry. But of course, if you look at it, automation came from the manufacturing industry, the Toyota way of working, right? And I'm sure if you look up in Google or look up in the literature on how Toyota implemented automation, you will get many instances how to implement automation in different industry other than IT.
Excellent. And one last question maybe to wrap up. The question was around inclusion and diversity. What are the challenges in terms of setting up an inclusive culture in the times when people do not have face-to-face interactions?
Perfect. So the first thing, be it be face-to-face or be it be virtual, right? The first thing is find out your unconscious bias. You know, I was in a coaching network, agile coaching network, called the other webinar, And Ray Errol, who is one of the board of directors of Agile Alliance, he was saying that 95% of our reaction is because of our unconscious bias. Things like women are not good drivers. Oh, I really don't believe that. But yes, we think about it that way. So when you see someone making a mistake, you assume it must be a woman in the behind the wheel, right? So first, try to find out what is your unconscious bias. It need not be face-to-face, need not be virtual. But if you are conscious about your unconscious bias, you can definitely take care of yourself. And if you take care of yourself as a manager and a leader, you're leading by example. And that's how you build an inclusive culture. And I believe it has nothing to do with the virtual way of working. It is something that comes from within.
Absolutely. And thank you very much. In spite of all the busy things that you do, thank you for joining us today. And have a good rest of the conference with us. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.